Never lie to an X-ray technician. They can see right through you. Hi everyone, Julie here for DNews. Most of us have gotten an X-ray at some point, either at the dentist or maybe when we break a bone, but I always had to wear an uncomfortable heavy lead apron. And that makes me wonder, are X-rays safe? And how the hell can they see through me? X-rays are another form of electromagnetic energy, which is a long spectrum. Visible light, which we can see, just makes a tiny part of it. On one end are radio waves and on the other end, gamma rays. X-rays have waves that have a higher energy and are a little longer than gamma rays, but a little shorter than visible light. We can't see them, but they can sure see through us. They were discovered in 1895 when a German scientist was experimenting with passing electrical currents through gas and tubes. These tend to light up when hit with electrons, so Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen covered up one of his tubes with a box, but he noticed something strange. An object nearby glowed. He assumed that some type of energy was getting through the box, but wasn't light. But he didn't know what kind of energy it was, so he called it X, hence X-ray. He found that it passed easily through some objects, like our soft tissues, but not through other objects, like our bones or lead. He produced the first image of an X-ray by taking a radiograph of his wife's hand in 1895. It was heralded as a medical miracle. Suddenly, the new technology took off. Everybody was using it to find breaks in bones or bullets lodged in bodies. But soon, people noticed some problems. Early X-ray technicians started having skin problems on their hands. Their skin would get dry and scaly, or they'd get burns, or their hair would fall out. After a while, the damage would be so severe they'd have to amputate fingers, hands, sometimes whole arms. Dozens of people died from radiation exposure. But no one really seemed to take heed. People still used X-rays for removing unwanted facial hair or for shoe fittings in department stores. Not surprisingly, people got sick. Women who got X-ray treatment to remove hair wound up with dry, scaly skin, enlarged blood vessels, and finally, some developed cancer. But is it safe now? Well, we certainly learned our lesson from those early days. X-rays are still considered a carcinogen by the World Health Organization, and one study published in the journal Cancer found a link for a slight increased risk for certain brain cancers and frequent dental X-rays. Another study published in the journal Lancet found an up to 6% risk of cancer from diagnostic X-rays. But we have come a long way. Medical X-rays in the 50s used almost 100 times the radiation now considered acceptable. Basically, the amount of radiation during an X-ray is pretty small. According to the FDA, an X-ray of your bones and your hands or feet is pretty comparable to a day's worth of natural background radiation. But other procedures have different levels of exposure. And there are enormous benefits to X-rays. The pros by far outweigh the cons. They're an incredible diagnostic tool. They find things like bone breaks, blood clots, tumors, and many, many more things you really want to know about without invasive exploratory surgery. And don't be afraid to ask questions. Make sure it's medically necessary and ask to wear the protective shields. They're like a lead apron or a neck guard. And since radiation is cumulative over the course of your life, keep track of your X-ray history and make sure your medical professional knows. X-rays catch far more cases of cancer than they cause. Speaking of catching cancer, it seems South Korea is overdiagnosing this disease. To find out why, check out this great video from my buddy Evan over at Seeker Daily.
Interestingly though, most experts agree that this fact is not because of an actual increase in the disease, only an increase in the number of people being screened for it.
And don't forget to subscribe to their channel. They've got great videos for the adventurer and all of us. All right, guys, got any questions about other medical mysteries? Let us know down in the comments below. And don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.